ladies, and welcome back to The Single Mother's Life. If you're new here, welcome. And if you've been rocking with me for a while, thank you so, so much. My name is Latarsha, and I am a confidence life coach, speaker, and author. And I help single mothers live boldly and confidently using biblical wisdom. In today's video, we are going to talk about a popular question that I've been getting. How do I find housing when I'm relocating? So stay tuned. So I've been receiving emails from many of you asking, okay, so I watch your videos, I hear what you're saying, I really want to relocate, but how do I find housing? How do I prove that I make three times the income, which is what most apartment complexes are requiring you to do now? Well, I'm gonna go ahead and break that down, girl, because I too was in that same situation. But as I always say, everyone's situation is not the same. We all have our own unique situation. So what worked for me may not work for you. So here's what I did. When I relocated 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago now, from Alabama here to Austin, Texas, I was working from home. So I was working from home. I was making pretty good money, which, you know, some of you are making pretty good money, but it's not, you know, enough. But I was making pretty good money. And what I also did is I picked up another job for a food delivery company. I picked up another job for a food delivery company, and on my application, I gave them the name of that food delivery company, and I just gave them I just put the headquarters address on the application. I didn't say this is waiter, because it was waiter food service at that time, which wasn't everywhere at that time. They were still kind of new. So I didn't give them any details. I only put on the application what they asked me. No one called me and said, hey, what's waiter? Or hey, you said that waiter is in California, but you're in Mobile. They didn't say that. All they did is, which I don't know if they even verified waiter. I know they verified my full-time job, or I think they verified my full-time job, but I'm not sure. I don't know. I don't care. All I know is I got approved for that apartment complex. And another thing is, the apartment complex that I got approved at, they didn't check all of that. They didn't check all of that because I used an apartment locator and I told him my unique situation, and the apartment locator led me to the apartment complex that really didn't check all of that. All they required was a full rent deposit along with your first month's deposit. So you had to pay your full month rent, and then you had to pay a deposit which was equal to your full month rent at that apartment complex. And it was a nice gated community, really, really nice. But I told y'all my story as to why I ended up having to move from that particular apartment complex. I got approved because I used an apartment locator. I told him my unique situation, which leads me to the first way that you can get housing when you're relocating is to use an apartment locator. So use an apartment locator and they will lead you to where you need to go. Just let them know what you're looking for. Let them know your unique situation and they will say, well, okay, well, I have an entire list of apartment complexes that will fit your situation. And then they'll give you that list. You can call them or do whatever you want. You could go visit those apartment complexes, and then you can find housing that way. Second way to find housing when relocating and prove that you make three times the rent is to let them know that you're self-employed. You would have to be self-employed now. You can't lie. But in addition to your full-time job, you need to pick up some other type of hustle, which would be considered as self-employment, because technically you're self-employed. Whether you do DoorDash, whether you Uber, whether you do Lyft, whether you sell hair out of your house, whether you sell clothes, whether you babysit, whether you clean homes, whatever the case may be, if you're not employed by someone, you're an independent contractor, then you are self-employed. So if you say, I need another source of income, you know, I need to increase my income by maybe $1,000 a month so that I could get approved for this apartment complex, and you don't want to get another full-time job, or you don't want to be employed by someone else, you want to do your own thing, then you may want to consider driving for a rideshare company such as Uber or Lyft, or you may want to consider doing DoorDash or Favor or Waiter or Grubhub or whatever you have in your area. You may want to consider doing that, and that in itself is considered income. It's self-employment income because you're considered as an independent contractor, and independent contractors are considered as self-employed. So if you're like, well, I don't want to go out, I want to stay home and do something, then check out tsmlsolutions.com. And I have plenty of work from home call centers on there. You can make up to $17 an hour. Pick your own schedule and you work from the comfort of your own home. Now, this is a good choice because not only will you pick up an additional source of income that will help you prove that you make three times the rent, but when you relocate to that new place, you also have continuous employment because we work with the majority of the states. So we have to make sure that you're going to a state, or you're relocating to a state that we work in. My third and final solution to you in order to find housing when you relocate is start small. You know, the Bible tells us not to despise small beginnings, and it's not like you're settling or anything, but you can start off in that 2-bedroom apartment until you can work your way up financially to that 3-bedroom apartment. So start small, you know, start looking for something that's in your current price range. Like, we're virtual right now, so most of our jobs will transfer us and we'll be able to work from home. So you already have your income, which is what makes right now a great time to relocate due to us, you know, our jobs, they're most likely to transfer us because everything is virtual. And even if your job won't transfer you, it won't be hard to find a job that is, you know, remote. So it's okay to, you know, say, okay, I'll get this 2-bedroom, or maybe a 1-bedroom. I'll get this 1-bedroom, I'll get this 2-bedroom, but it's not forever. It's only for a year. I'll work, you know, my way up financially. I'll get to the city, I'll explore opportunities, I'll bring in more money for me and my children, and then, you know, we will work our way up to this 3-bedroom or to this house, whatever you want, whatever your goals are. It doesn't hurt to start small or to start where you are financially so that you can get in that, so that you can actually get in the city. This video is really, really short. I hope it helped. Again, if you need more resources, if you need more tools, if you need more motivation as far as relocating as a single mother, I have written a book, The Single Mother's 5-Step Guide to Relocate with No Support. It is on Amazon, and it helps you think strategically. It kind of goes a little deeper than what I'm going on in this video. So you definitely want to pick you up a copy. And if you do pick up a copy, let me know how you like it. I love you, ladies, and I will talk to you in my next video.